20 incarnations of the Doctor exist, and I'm going to do my best to rank them from 20 all the way up to number 1. Let's go. Alright, at number 20, we have the Fugitive Doctor, Joe Martin.
Let me take it from the top. Hello, I'm the Doctor.
This one pretty much speaks for itself. We just haven't had a lot of time with that Doctor. I feel like that Doctor was underutilized as well, so it just comes in at number 20. Alright, at number 19, we have the Valeyard, Michael Jayston.
The Valeyard is an amalgamation of the darker sides of your nature, somewhere between your 12th and final incarnation.
An incredibly interesting concept to put into Doctor Who, in an evil version of the Doctor, a version of the Doctor between now and the end of his regenerations, the end of his life, where he turns evil. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. But I'd love to see the Valeyard return, but it's not a concept that we've seen come back. It hasn't returned yet. Only been whispers of it once every now and again. An underutilized idea that we haven't been able to spend that much time with. Just puts it at the bottom of this list. At number 18, we have the Metacrisis Doctor, David Tennant.
It's you!
Oh, yes.
You're naked!
Oh, yes.
I love this idea of the Metacrisis Doctor. I absolutely love that Rose got her happy ending. I love that we got to see at least a version of the Doctor get that happy ending with Rose that we saw. I love that universe has its own David Tennant now too, and its own Doctor. That's cool and fantastic and awesome. But I just think there was so much more to do with the Metacrisis Doctor that we just didn't get to see because of the short amount of time that we got to spend with him. So, yeah. At number 17, we have the Shalka Doctor, Richard E. Grant.
And that's the Master who I see isn't holding on to anything. And this... is a black hole.
Fantastic. Easily the best animated Doctor Who that they've done. I know the BBC are now recreating old Doctor Who episodes, missing episodes of Doctor Who, by using the audio that they have and recreating the video with animation. However, this is the best animated Doctor Who that we've seen. Richard E. Grant kills it. It's fantastic. I absolutely loved this one when I was a kid, but we haven't seen him return. We haven't really had much time with this Doctor. Wildly underrated, but unfortunately makes it to this spot. At number 16, we have the War Doctor, John Hurt.
Great men are forged in fire. It is the privilege of lesser men to light the flame. Whatever the cost.
Again, another version of the Doctor, which we didn't really get to spend a lot of time with. I love John Hurt. I absolutely love John Hurt in everything that he's been in. He was such a fantastic actor, and I'm so happy that before the end of his life, he got to be in Doctor Who in this way. He got to be a version of the Doctor, and not just a version, but the War Doctor. Like, maybe the coolest version of the Doctor that we get to see. His portrayal was fantastic. His performance was amazing. But again, we only got to spend a short amount of time with him. So, yeah. At number 15, we have the 14th Doctor, David Tennant.
I've never been so happy in my life.
Just like a lot of the other Doctors at the bottom of this list, we didn't really get to spend a lot of time with the 14th Doctor. We got three 60th specials, which were fantastic, but I feel like there's still more there. I feel like there's more potential for this Doctor. I really love that he got his happy ending with Donna. I love that he got his family and he's slowing down a little, but I feel like there is a whole spin-off series that is waiting to happen there that we just haven't got yet. At number 14, we have the 8th Doctor, Paul McGann.
Charlie. Carries Lucy, Tamsin, and Molly. Friends, companions I've known, I salute you. And Cass, I apologize.
I love Paul McGann. I love that they brought him back for the preludes to the 50th anniversary special. I actually really, really enjoyed the Doctor Who TV movie as well. I love that he's come back and he's done so many audio adventures as well. Unfortunately, this Doctor didn't resonate with me as much as all the other Doctors on this list. So it's no hard feelings, but this is just where I've placed him. At number 13, we have the Technicolor coat wearing Sixth Doctor, Colin Baker.
Decadent, degenerate, and rotten to the core. Power Met conspirators, Daleks, Sontarans, Cybermen. They're still in the nursery compared to us. 10 million years of absolute power. That's what it takes to be really corrupt.
Take it easy, Doc.
I think, unfortunately, this is the first Doctor on this list that's been hard done by the production and by the writing and the showrunners itself. Whilst Colin Baker had larger and grander ideas for his Doctor than the show would allow, he was very hard done by the writing and the show running and the production and the BBC at the time. And unfortunately, because of that, we didn't get to see a lot of his Doctor on screen and didn't get to spend the time with him that was needed for, at least myself, to engage with him properly. So unfortunately, he can't make it any higher than this for me. At number 12, we have the second Doctor, Patrick Troughton.
Come.
Fantastic. What a actor. What a Doctor. The first person to take over from William Hartnell, the first Doctor that had been regenerated into, he really carried the torch for the show. Patrick Troughton is very, very responsible for the fact that we still have Doctor Who going today, over 60 years later, which is why he's at a very well-deserved number 12 spot. Coming in at number 11, we have the 13th Doctor, Jodie Whittaker.
How many times do you think you've saved Earth?
I've lost count. But look at it. How could you not love a planet like that?
I love Jodie. I love her acting. I love her range. If you haven't seen Broadchurch, if you haven't seen her in Attack the Block, if you haven't seen her in anything else, she's fantastic. She's so, so good. Controversially, I actually really, really like Jodie Whittaker's Doctor. I really, really enjoyed the Flux series. I think that in the moments where she was allowed to shine, she really, really shined. But similarly to Colin Baker, she was hard done by the show running, the writing, and the direction of the show. So unfortunately, she can't make it any higher than this, but I do love her Doctor, and I think she did a really, really amazing job. All right, we are now into the top 10. This list, from this point on, was so, so difficult to try and organize. Good Lord. Coming in at number 10, we have the third Doctor, John Pertwee.
How many times have I told you? Violence will never get you anywhere.
My God, fantastic. The thing I remember most about the third Doctor is the velvet was like the magician-y sort of cape, was the yellow car, was Sarah Jane, was the Brigadier, was Adventures on Earth, and I absolutely loved it as a kid. It was weird, it was zany, and he was fantastic. He used to karate chop people and like, I loved it. I absolutely loved it. It was fantastic. A very well-earned spot on this list. At number 9, we have the 7th Doctor, Sylvester McCoy.
See? Every great decision creates ripples. Like a huge boulder dropped in a lake. The ripples merge, rebound off the banks in unforeseeable ways. The heavier the decision, the larger the waves, the more uncertain the consequences.
I love the 7th Doctor's adventures with Ace. I loved it when he faced off against the Master. I loved absolutely everything about his Doctor. His get-up, the questions, the everything. Sylvester McCoy as a person is fantastic. I love that he was a little bit manipulative even. Like, I just all round loved his Doctor. And it's a very, very well-earned spot for him on this list. Fantastic. Very, very good. Sylvester McCoy, fantastic Doctor. At number 8, we have the 15th Doctor, Shruti Gatwa.
I'm not a Doctor. Something much older and far more powerful. I'm a lord of time from a lost and fallen planet of Gallifrey. Now let me go, bounty hunter.
I love Shruti's performance. I absolutely love the range that he brings. I love the emotion that he brings to the Doctor, and I love what we've seen of him so far. But he's only been in this for one season. I think we still need to see him prove himself a little bit more as the Doctor. what I will say is that I am really, really jealous of the current generation that's going to get to grow up having the 15th Doctor be their Doctor. I can't wait to see more of him. I can't wait to see, hopefully over the years, he climbs up higher and higher over this list. But at the moment, this is where he's at. At number 7, we have the 5th Doctor, Peter Davison.
Maverick, yes, there is a difference between serious scientific investigation and meddling.
Yes.
Isn't there?
Yes.
Peter was left with a nigh near impossible task, which was to take over for Tom Baker, which at the time was the most popular Doctor that had been on Doctor Who. I absolutely love the cricket getup. I absolutely love the celery. It's so weird and out of place, and just still to this day, makes no sense. I love all the adventures we got with him and the Cyberman. I love the moments that hit us right in our emotions, like Adric and... I really, really like the 5th Doctor. Some of my favourite episodes of all time are from his run as the Doctor. Which is why he's at number 7. At number 6, we have the OG, the original himself, the 1st Doctor, William Hartnell.
One day, I shall come back. Yes, I shall come back. Until then, there must be no regrets, no tears, no anxieties. Just go forward in all your beliefs and prove to me that I am not mistaken in mine.
Also played by David Bradley and Richard Herndl. If you've watched classic Doctor Who, you'll know how much William Hartnell means to the fandom, but he was a grandfather to us all. He was a cranky and sometimes crotchety, angry man that now when you look back at it said out of pocket shit. First Doctor will always hold such a special place in my heart because he was the first Doctor that I ever saw on screen. He was the first Doctor that I ever watched. Thanks to William Hartnell that I love the show so much and that I got into Doctor Who. So, very well earned 6th place on this list. Now we're into the top 5. Alright, coming in at number 5, we have the 9th Doctor. Christopher Eccleston.
Your race is dead. You all burn, all of you. 10 million ships on fire. The entire Dalek race wiped out in 1 second.
Goodbye!
I watched it happen.
I made it happen.
You destroyed us!
Part of the reason why Doctor Who doesn't just exist as audio adventures or was completely cancelled altogether was because of Christopher Eccleston. I enjoyed Christopher Eccleston's portrayal of Doctor so much that when David Tennant came along, I wasn't happy about it. I wanted Chris to stay. I wanted my 9th Doctor to stay. I loved seeing that essence of the War Doctor scattered throughout that series, and watching him battle with himself on screen was fantastic. And it's a very, very well-earned spot. Coming in at number 4, ironically enough, is the 4th Doctor, Tom Baker.
If someone who knew the future pointed out a child to you and told you that that child would grow up totally evil, to be a ruthless dictator who would destroy millions of lives, could you then kill that child?
I love his hat, I love his scarf, I love his jacket, I love his adventures with the Sontarans, I love everything he did with Sarah Jane. I love all the animated episodes of Doctor Who that the BBC have now brought back to life, starring Tom Baker. They are my favourite.
Would you like a jelly baby?
When I was a kid, my dad would come home from work and he'd have a bag of sweets and he would say, would you like a jelly baby? Even though they weren't jelly babies, just because he knew how much I liked that Doctor as a kid. It's just... I love Tom Baker, I love the Doctor, I love the actor, the man, the character, I love just everything. It's fantastic. Coming in at number 3, we have the 11th Doctor, Matt Smith.
We all change when you think about it. We are all different people, all through our lives. And that's okay, that's good, you've got to keep moving so long as you remember all the people that you used to be.
Similarly to David Tennant's first run in Doctor Who, I wasn't sold. Right up until the end of the first episode. And when we got that I am the Doctor speech, when we got that moment of him saying, basically, run. Ooh. Matt Smith brought something to this role that was sorely needed in my opinion at the time. And that was a mix and a balance of the light and the dark. We got the goofy Doctor, but we also got those sad, desperate moments where he was angry and rageful and vengeful, and I absolutely loved it. I love Matt Smith's Doctor. I loved his companions. I loved it all. Very, very well earned third place on this list. At number two, we have the 12th Doctor, Peter Capaldi.
I don't know what to do with all that pain. Shall I tell you where you put it? You hold it tight till it burns your hand. And you say this. No one else will ever have to live like this. No one else will ever have to feel this pain. Not on my watch.
Before he was announced as the Doctor, I had always wanted Peter Capaldi to be the Doctor. I had always loved Peter's acting. If you didn't know, in the show Skins, Peter plays Sid's dad, and I loved him in that role. And he was always, always one of my top picks to be the Doctor. And then he got announced as the Doctor. It was like it was made for him. It was like the role was made for him. Three episodes, Face the Raven, Heaven Sent, and Hell Sent, might be some of the most perfect episodes of Doctor Who ever. I love them so, so much, and I love Peter Capaldi's run as the Doctor. He embodied the Doctor for me in a way that I hadn't seen in a long, long time. Coming in at number one, we have the 10th Doctor, David Tennant.
I could do so much more! So much more! But this is what I get. My reward. But it's not fair!
I think this one sort of speaks for itself. David really was the Doctor for my generation of kids. He was the Doctor for a lot of people. I think his portrayal of the Doctor is one of the most interesting and one of the most layered performances that we've seen. There's a reason why they bring David back all the time. There's a reason why he came back for the 60th anniversary specials. There's a reason why he was back for the 50th. He likes being the Doctor, and we like having him as the Doctor. I loved his suits, I loved his fashion, I love the episodes, I love the writing, I love his adventures with the Master, I love his adventures with the Daleks and the Cybermen and everything. Just those David Tennant seasons of Doctor Who hold such an unbelievably special place in my heart. And there's no way he couldn't be at my number one spot. In the comments, let me know your top 10 Doctors, yeah? Not the full 20, I'm not gonna get you to do that, but your top 10 favorite Doctors, let me know who they are. Some of the Doctors on this list are a little bit more interchangeable than others, but I'm pretty happy with it. I think it's a good looking list. I'm happy with this list. I think that's it. See me in the next one.